America, land of the free, home of the brave. Possibility, potential, dreams realized. That's the good. Then there's the bad, even ugly. Political tension, racial and economic division, drugs, guns, and war. 30 Seconds to Mars' ambitious new project tackles it all head on. The album is called America. It is out now. Academy Award winner Jared Leto is the band's lead singer. He joins me now here in LA. Welcome.
Hi.
Congrats.
By the way, that intro, I want to take it and play it before every show. It was so classy and so impactful, powerful. Sounded great.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. The album sounds great. It is your first album in 5 years.
Yeah.
A lot of people have been waiting for it. A lot of people have been excited. You know, it's called America. It's a big sweeping title. This is a big sweeping album.
Yeah.
But I guess my question to you is this more personal or political?
It's a little bit of both. It's social, it's personal, it's emotional, creative and fun, provocative maybe at times. A thin line, the whole truth. This is a new chapter for 30 Seconds to Mars, and America is a very heavy-handed title, especially in the times we're living in now, which is one of the reasons we have these crazy album covers, these lists.
Talk about that.
Yeah.
What is the thinking behind, is it 10 different album covers?
I mean, there are hundreds of different lists that we're using on billboards and snipes, street posters on album covers.
Yeah. What's the thinking here? What conversation are you trying to start?
Well, I think individually the lists for me are, they could be fun or funny, provocative, they're interesting, they're bizarre. But together they kind of act like a time capsule. If you were to look back on these lists 10, 20, 30, 50, 100 years from now, I think you'd get a sense of the times that we're living in, the culture that we're all a part of.
You did this cross country.
Yeah.
I don't want to call it migration. I don't know what the word.
Odyssey.
Oh, no, it was an odyssey. That's a
long
perfect
walk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
First of all, why did you want to do that for this album?
Well, the album's called America.
Yeah.
And I thought retracing that journey that I took as a kid, coming from New York, an art school kid, art school dropout, coming to California for the first time with my backpack and sleeping on Venice Beach. There was something to kind of retracing my steps. It's a classic journey from east to west. I got a chance to visit states that we're going to be playing shows at for our tour in June and July. And I got on the streets. I got in front of people, you know, talking to a trucker in Milwaukee who's shipping Harley Davidsons across the nation and hearing about his concerns of the future. So I don't know. It was very much in line with the album. And in the spirit of what we're doing, and it was an incredible trip. I met the most amazing people, and I had an experience of a lifetime.
What surprised you on the journey?
What surprised
me? These people?
What surprised me was the optimism that's still out there in the midst of such conflict and times of instability and uncertainty, that people still hold on to hope.
What are they optimistic about their own selves as individuals to push through, or of the country as a collective?
The country as a collective. I think the idea of the American dream, the idea of America, the possibility that we can leave this country in a better place for our children and our children's children. I think people still held on to that, acknowledging that we're in really difficult times, but looking forward and hopeful that things can be different.
Can we get better? Heck yes.
I have that hope that America can change for the better.
Everything I have today is thanks to the United States.
It's a land of opportunity.
Possibility.
America is greater than it's ever been.
There's something positive that's going to come out of the negativity.
Are you optimistic?
I'm optimistic. I mean, I see a lot of unity out there. I mean, if you looked at the news, you obviously get a sense of the conflict in the country. You get a sense of the uncertainty of the debate and discussion that's going on. But when you cross the country, I think you see that we have a lot more in common than maybe expected.
Another night, another war. Another war are we fighting for? A lot of lost, a bit of pain. Oh, is everybody out here crazy?
The song that you have on the album, Hail to the Victor, which, you know, is taking, again, some really big, big issues, concepts. You were talking about war, religion, drugs. But as the song was listened to in the office, you know, the feeling was that it's still a very hopeful song.
Yeah, I think so. I think there are songs in this album that are filled with optimism and hope, and songs that talk about the times that we're living in. There's a song called Walk on Water.
I love that.
Yeah, thank you. It's about freedom. It's about standing up and fighting for what you believe in. And that's important, you know, not just in this time, but in any time.
When people go to these concerts, when they see you on stage and in the days ahead, do you want them to leave with a particular feeling? Do you want them to take something in particular away from this album? I mean, some creatives say no. They want people to take what they find and what they identify with.
I mean, if I had my way, I would love people to feel good. I would love people to feel some sense of possibility. I think when people come to a concert and there's 10 or 20,000 people in a room sharing the same idea, that's very unique, especially in the times that we're living in. You get a big group of people agreeing on something. And I hope that people leave with a sense of excitement, that they had a night that they'll never forget. And, you know, I work really hard every night to make sure that that happens.
Jared Leto, such a pleasure.
Yeah, nice to talk
to you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. And the news continues right after this. You're watching CNN.